say Rico Fafuasi. Stretch up!
Chorus music.
Hi guys, it's Asiya, and so I just wanted to try and review some of the makeup brushes that I got from Amazon. I'm gonna post the link below, but it comes in a pink package like this. It's called I Love Cos. I'm guessing it's I Love Cosmetics. But I just recently purchased this and I haven't used any of the brushes, so I just wanted to go through the brushes and like just talk about them and what they do, because I didn't know what half of them did. So I actually googled and like tried to find what the different brushes do. So this is what it looks like when it comes. Nice and pretty and pink. And the big brushes come with like a little protective sleeve thing so that it keeps the bristles from like breaking or whatever, or just getting destroyed. Yeah, these bristles are really, really soft. I love them. So let's go through the brushes together. Okay, so this one is the fan brush, the large fan brush. And I guess this one is used for highlighting. So you could just have a nice soft highlight like that. I'll go through my favorite brushes first and then the rest can follow. This is the lash comb and brush. This is probably one of my favorite because yes, my brows stay on fleek. So this just is used to like brush the brow hairs. I like this one just to mix the brown liner after I've like put it on my brows. I use it to kind of like just, you know, mix it up and make it look more natural. And this is also one of my favorite, the little spoolie. I can't live without these. Like, they're really good to just brush the brows again. If you don't want to like do your brows or whatever, go with the natural brow. Brush it and you're done. Which other ones are my fave? This brush, I have a brush like this. I use this as my contouring or foundation brush. And it's like sort of flat. But yeah, I use it to just like put all my foundation and concealer, and it makes it nice and even. This is one of my favorite brushes. Can't wait to use this one. This one as well. This one's like a blush brush. So, you know, you do the duck face, the fishy face, and just go down here and down here, right below your highlight, because you don't want to mix the blush with the highlights. My other favorite is this brush. This one's kind of small. I have a bigger one right now. But this brush, I would probably use this angled brush to define my brows and like put the concealer underneath and on top and blend, because we do not like that halo effect. Yes. Okay, now for the brushes that I do not use. This is the smudger. It just smudges eyeshadows and stuff, I guess, when you want a smoky eye. I'm not really a fan of eyeshadows because I'm still learning, so I don't know how to do it. So that's why I don't put eyeshadow. That's the only reason. But it looks really pretty on other people, so that's the smudger. And then this is the sponge eyeshadow brush. This is the one that comes in like every eyeshadow palette type of thing. And it's usually like really short, but this one is super long. Use it for eyeshadow. And then there's a small fan brush. I don't know what I would use this for, because I've never I guess I would use it for like highlighting just the nose part and down there and the little, like the smaller highlighting areas. Then there's the liner brush to get that, you know, nice winged eye, which is like my go-to. I love winged eye. Almost always perfect. I try. Yeah, so this is the liner brush. And then we have the angled brush, which I talked about already. And then we have these three brushes, which look pretty much the same to me, but I'm guessing that one of them is a lip brush and the other one is like a small concealer brush. I don't know. But I guess you can use these for whatever you want to use them for, because there's so many brushes in here. What else do we have in the magic bag? I don't know what these ones are for either, but I guess these are also concealer brushes. There's an angled one. Yeah, they're like more sturdy, so I guess if you want to like put your contouring and stuff like that. And then we have four eyeshadow brushes. These ones have a soft, they have a brown, they have brown hairs because they're much softer than the white ones. And I guess that helps with the eyeshadow like blending and everything and just getting on there. This one's flat. And then these three are just round. This one's the bigger one, medium size and small. I would use these for eyeshadow. Then we have the small concealer brush, just to put any of the imperfections, blot. Still learning with my makeup, so this is gonna be fun. And then this is the large foundation brush that I already talked about. I love how this feels. And the blush brush that I talked about already. And then I do not know what these two brushes are for, but I'm guessing this is a powder brush, because the large ones is just to put powder evenly on your face, get that nice finished look. I guess this is a smaller powder brush. Yeah, so if you didn't know what any of these brushes do, now you do, sort of. There's a few that I didn't know, but this is really, really nice, and they seem very strong, and they weren't too expensive. So if you're starting off like a beginner with makeup and stuff, I recommend this. I recommend you buy this one, because it's like cheaper brushes but for a good quality, so you don't have to buy those expensive brushes for like just one brush. Can be a crazy amount. Let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Health, wealth, and happiness.